And I'll have to admit one thing. Even though there are a lot of preparation that's being put in, there is a small amount of luck that has to work out in your favor. So luck does do something, but on the flip side, there is a lot amount of preparation you have to put first. Only then you can expect the luck to work out in your favor.
Hi everyone, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today I have a very special guest, Sarvan Kumar. He has cleared RBI Grade B 2021 examination. The results have been declared very recently. And today I will be talking with him about his strategy, how he prepared, the failures that he went in life, that he went through in his life, how he transformed them into success. We will be talking about all those things. First of all, Sarvan, congratulations to you on
Thank
getting
you.
Selected.
Thank you very much.
Yes. As you said, this is your first attempt in RBI examination, yes. And it's a great feat. I must admit, it's a great achievement to have cleared this examination in first attempt itself.
Thank you.
Having said that, can you just introduce yourself to all the aspirants about your timeline, about your work experience, about your education, so that they have a better idea?
Sure. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for having on board on this program. I'm Saravana Kumar. I'm from Chennai, Tamil Nadu. So I got graduated in 2016 as a mechanical engineer from Chennai. So after doing my graduation, I thought of preparing for civil service examination and started my preparation for the same. For three continuous years, I had given civil services mains. I was fortunate enough to clear prelims every time. But unfortunately, things did not work up. So I was not able to clear the civil services mains all the three times. So with a broken heart and with a difficult financial personal situation, I thought of exploring my own avenues in order to make up the situation. So right then I was fortunate enough to, in the year of 2020, I was fortunate enough to get into an IT company. So I was working with Infosys for 2.5 years. After getting into it, now I had the self-confidence, I had the personal financial backup, which I badly wanted. So after getting into that, now I wanted to expand my own frontiers. So I decided to start my own preparation. But right then, the time which was available then working in a private firm was not sufficient enough to prepare for UPSC. So it was a little difficult. I'm not saying it's not perfectly impossible, but it was difficult for me working in a private firm and preparing for UPSC. So that's a point wherein I thought of exploring other avenues as well. So right then and put out, charted out what are the various examinations which I could appear for. The things which came in mind were SBI PO, IBBS PO, all these banking related examination, NABARD, Railway Recruitment Board, and Reserve Bank of India, Grade B and Assistant as well. So I started my preparation with these things in mind. So in the year of 2021, I was fortunate enough to clear SBI PO and IBBS PO on a straight set. So now I'm employed as State Bank of India probationary officer. After which the Reserve Bank of India Grade B examination happened and I gave it on a straight way. So at this point of time, the prelims, mains, everything went off and there was increasing pandemic as well. So at this point of time, I had put in a lot of efforts to not ensure that I have a streamlined preparation. So again, the Grade B results have come in the last week. So I was fortunate enough to get into as well.
Congrats again. I think the biggest takeaway that I could take out as a listener is that UPSC is not the end of life. And if it does not work out, it does not mean that you are a failure in life. And
exactly.
everything comes at its own pace in its own time span. And it's very heartening to see for me, especially that you moved on quickly enough, took up something that you were good at in the time period, adapted to the situation. And then you came back, bouncing back again. I think that's a very positive approach and that requires a lot of courage. That requires a lot of humbleness, a lot of courage, a lot of belief in yourself. That's very important. I see a lot of students, to be very honest, who get bogged down by these kind of failures and who are unable to, pick themselves up again.
Yes.
And this is actually destroying their lives. Their entire lives are affected because of this. So if the students can take away this small learning, this small lesson from you, I think it will be great.
Yeah. Obviously, the timeline which I've been through was a perfect roller coaster. Like, I faced continuous failures after UPSC, wherein I was not having the self-confidence which I was destined to. So bringing about the self-confidence was the thing which I was supposed to work on. So that made the thing work.
Perfect. Perfect. I think you've done a beautiful job here at, you know, bouncing back again and giving yourself that time that you needed to, you know, get yourself up again, read more and more to make up for all those differences, all those gaps in your prep probably. And also to let those bad times pass away so that the, you know, good times come and then you can strike it, strike at it and, you know, get successful. Amazing. So, Saravan, moving forward, I think you would have a, you know, very clear and crisp strategy about phase one and phase two. So can you just start with phase one? How did you prepare for quant reasoning in English and general awareness? And then we'll talk about phase two.
Yeah, sure. So while we are talking about phase one, it's more of general reasoning, aptitude, English, current affairs. So taking these into aspects, we'll have to divide the weightage, what everything needs to be. So with respect to quants and reasoning, you'll have to practice daily. So on this hat, this has to be a routine. So you'll not have to be missing out even a single day of your routine so that you won't keep a long distance out of it. So with quants and reasoning, you'll have to have practice daily. So that's a very first mantra which you'll have to keep up. And with respect to current affairs, so you'll have to stick to two newspapers. So that's my own thing. I'm sticking to two newspapers daily. So since Reserve Bank of India is an examination that demands a financial knowledge and also a little bit of current general current affairs, I was sticking to the Hindu and the Business Standard. So these two newspapers I was sticking out daily so that I don't miss any of the important current affairs. And with respect to general English, it's more of enough if you have general knowledge about English. So if you are able to interpret whatever what's found in the daily newspapers, that's more of enough. So that's more enough. That's the main strategy with respect to phase one. So apart from this, you'll have to work out a lot of mocks. So at least one mock a day will make your day. So that's what I say to myself. So if you're going to miss even one day, that will put you back of others. So that's the thing which thing, because every day I see more of people doing a lot of mocks. They do 2-3 mocks. But if you don't do even one mock, that's going to put you back of the seat. So there is a lot of competition. We see 4 to 5 lakhs people competing for 270 seats. That's a high amount of competition wherein you'll have to put in a bit of extra effort to make the things done. So that's with respect to the phase one. And with respect to phase two, I find the syllabus now being revised. So the syllabus is more oriented towards UPSC. And that does not mean like non-UPSC preparing candidate cannot do this. So that's completely a myth. So UPSC candidate had a little bit of understanding over the syllabus more. But that does not make the non-UPSC candidates are not in a place to do this. So like what we stuck to UPSC, like stick to the syllabus genuinely. You'll have to stick to the syllabus. So when we writing the grade B phase two examination, I found that most of the questions were directly reflective of the syllabus. So I find that All India Financial Institution, that was a question that was put in grade B phase two examination. And that was exactly from the syllabus. So you should not miss out the syllabus. Every word of the syllabus is like your like whatever you call it, your holy book. So it has to be done genuinely with more effort. So every word is very, very important. You'll have to Google it. You'll have to go into the RBA website. You'll have to find whatever it is. You'll have to have a gist of answer. Yes, you will always depend upon other sources to prepare. But when you are preparing your own sources, it will make more gameful efforts, because like everybody will be going through prepared materials. But if you are putting one extra bit of effort and preparing in efficient notes, so that will bring out miracles. So that's the thing with respect to phase two. You should not miss even one single word of the syllabus. With respect to the phase three, it was more about personality tests rather than putting you in a knowledge-based question. So we had a video conferencing kind of physical interview, personal interview. So I had my interview in my Chennai Reserve Bank of India office. So what they wanted to test you was the basics and your personality. So the personality in the sense, you should be able to defend whatever answers you are up to, and you should be able to confidently tell them. So that's the thing that they are looking for. So for example, they had asked me a question. Since I was working with State Bank of India, they had a question about what are the KYC norms and why are they needed. So the basic of the KYC norms is knowing the customer, what is up to, providing the service needed. And above all, there is a thing called anti-money laundering and terrorism financing, which India has subscribed to. The main thing Reserve Bank of India is combating against thing is money laundering and combating financing, because we have subscribed to FATF organization, which we are obliged to do that.
Yes.
So these are the basic things which the panel looks for you. So on a totality, what the exam demands is getting your basic right and having the discipline. So these things will make you come out with flying colors.
Amazing, amazing. As I was saying, I think your preparation has been very top-notch, and you remember and understand every small, you know, part of the syllabus, every small part of the needs of the examination. And that's very beautiful to see. I think that's another learning that students should be taking, you know, from here, from you, that every part of the syllabus should be ingrained in your, you know, mental note.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to use that again and again every day. Coming to the descriptive part and the importance of mocks, although you pointed out the importance of mocks in phase one, I think it's a very important point to highlight here. How often did you write mocks for phase two, especially the descriptive part, whether it was, you know, self-checking those questions or getting them checked elsewhere, whatever it might be? How often did you practice writing?
I had missed this point very much. Since this phase two examination demands you writing in a keyboard, that is typing in a keyboard, you must be having the typing speed. So the first thing you'll have to get ready is to get accustomed with typing in a keyboard. So a lot of people don't know typing, but I was fortunate enough that I know typing well. So I had to. So I had the speed which the exam demanded. So the first thing you'll have to get accustomed with, you should start typing and get the speed if you don't have. So that's the first thing which you'll have to put in. The second thing is about drafting the answer. So there'll be a question put out to you. The question will be an open question. So there may be different parts of the question. You'll have to stick. You'll have to write the answer sticking to the question directly. So if they are asking about All India Financial Institution, you'll stick to the question and define what is All India Financial Institution, list them out and give a proper conclusion. Conclusion is going to be a very important part of an answer. So you stick to this part, introduction, main body and conclusion. If you are going to stick to this pattern, the answer will be a complete one. So that's one important thing. And regarding the practice for which I took for grade B examination, I made sure I write at least two answers daily. That's because I wanted to make sure I had the speed in typing and also make sure I had the flow of points whenever I wrote the questions. So whenever you see a question, you should be able to generate points at the instance of the time, because there is limited amount of time and you'll have to type the question in the keyboard. So there are some things which you'll be done with, and the interface that's being given, it's difficult at the first instance because you'll not be accustomed with the interface that you see in the monitor. So all these things will consume a lot of time. So you'll have to set an environment wherein you are provided these things. I hope all institutions provide these kind of mock. You'll have to get used to them, and you'll have to type in at least two answers daily. So and that was my own figure. If you are not confident enough, you can go up to five answers, six answers a day. That makes you confident enough. And the best thing is to like somebody should evaluate your answer, and you should be able to evaluate your answer as well. So these two things are more important. It's not like only someone should be evaluating your answer, or It's not like only you should be evaluating your answer. It's a combination of both. Even the second person has to evaluate your answer, and you'll have to evaluate your answer on your own. So only then you'll be able to know what's wrong there, what's right there, what improvement can be made there. And you should make sure that if the same question is being asked in the examination, you should give the 100% of your preparation. Because I know people who prepare for examination, but they who prepare for the same question, but they are not able to reproduce the same answer in the examination. That's the thing which people miss out. You should make sure that you are able to give the same 100% of what you wrote in the mock, the same in the examination as well.
I think that's a very, very important point, because when it comes to objective also, there are a lot of students who end up making silly mistakes, and therefore their accuracy goes down. And the same happens in descriptive also. A lot of students who prepare hard, who are good at it, but are not able to reproduce in the final exam.
And I'll have to admit one thing. Even though there are a lot of preparation that's being put in, there is a small amount of luck that has to work out in your favor. So luck does do something, but on the flip side, there is a lot amount of preparation you have to put first. Only then you can expect the luck to work out in your favor.
Right.
That's a thing which I'll have to admit, because clearing RBA in the first attempt, it's not a simple thing. Luck has to work out in your favor.
But I think it's 99% of your hard work, and then the 1% push that you get towards the end is your luck.
Which
basically forces, okay, he's working hard. 99% is already there. Let me play my role. Okay, I think you've already summarized majority of the things. I did not need to ask you a lot of questions. Majority of the questions that I had in mind, you already had them put out. Anything that you would want to share with the students before the end with the session? Anything, any message that you want to send out to the students?
Yes. So it's been 6 years that I've started up in preparation into examination. There were a lot of failures. I had to come across a lot of things. And there were a lot of critics who started talking about me, like, he's incapable, he's not able to do anything, he's not able to. So whenever you hear these kind of negative things, you'll have to stick to your own confidence. You'll have to boost up yourself. A thing. At the end of the day, it's you, only you, who can boost up yourself. So there'll be a lot of, you can't expect everyone to come and sit near you and hear you. It can't be done when you are being an adult. So it's at the end of the day, only you can boost yourself. And only at the end of the day, only you can be pushing yourself. So that's the thing which I wanted to tell my fellow aspirants. And I want to tell one more thing, like, there is light at the end of the tunnel. So obvious, there is going to be light, and it's like how fast you are going to reach it.
Very beautifully said. Very beautifully said. I think the fact that you've crossed all these hurdles and finally succeeded shows a lot about the experience that you have gained. And you're ready to accept the mistakes that you probably made, whatever you went through, and you're sharing it with all the other aspirants so that they don't have to probably go through the same. Or even if they do, they understand that, okay, there was another person who went through the same, and this is how he dealt with it. So we might as well, follow the same path and, learn from him and follow something better instead of getting bogged down by all these failures. Failures happen in everyone's life. To end with it, I would want to, I was watching very recently an interview by, there is a comedian called as Louis C.K. and a very, 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 very popular comedian of the United States. And he said that in 30 years of his career time span, for 26 years, he was a failure. And he felt that, after 26 years, he almost felt that he's going to be a failure for his entire life. He had accepted it. But he just kept working all these 26 years. And then finally, in the 27th year, it paid off. And for the last 4 years of his career, he was a very big, very big success. So that is how life turns out. It's different for all of us. It's unique for all of us. 6 years is not a small time. I must admit, it's a very, very long time span. And a lot of students give up in that time span. The fact that you took your time, came back, I think it talks a lot about, the courage that you took out. Thanks a lot, Sarvan, for coming out and talking to us. Thank you very much. It was a pleasure talking to you, I must admit. And I'm very, very sure that a lot of students are going to take out some, you know, positive points from your journey, from your life, and they're going to be able to use it very well in their life as well.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
All the best. Take care. Have a nice day.
Sure.